Hello chess fans, I hope you had a very nice day. And today's question is, who is the better player, Magnus Carlsen or Fabiano Caruana? I have to say, I like both players very much. They are very strong players. Magnus Carlsen, of course, is the world champion, but keep in mind, in the last World Championship match, they played 12-12 and had to go into a tiebreak. So in classical chess, Fabiano Caruana is maybe almost as good or even the same strength as the World Champion Magnus Carlsen. We all know Fabiano Caruana is a calculation monster. He has the ability to calculate very fast, very precise, and a lot of variations. Fabiano Caruana is, on the other hand, not so strong in the quick chess disciplines. That's why Magnus Carlsen went happily into the tiebreak, into rapid games, and I think also in blitz, Carlsen is better than Caruana, but in classical chess, he is as good as Carlsen. Caruana is a very good theoretical player. Magnus Carlsen, however, has not so much interest in opening theory. He doesn't want to study so much stuff. The strengths of Fabiano Caruana are opening theory, strategy and calculation, and of course tactics, which is also calculation. What is your opinion? Who is better, Magnus Carlsen or Fabiano Caruana? You can write your opinion and the reasons below the video into the comments. Let me know who you prefer and why. Who is the better chess player, Caruana or Carlsen? And that's the question today. For me, as I said, I like both players. For me, Carlsen is slightly better. The Elo is also better, and as I said, in the rapid and blitz games, he is better. In classical chess, they are almost the same strength, I think. And I have to say, Carlsen can calculate very, very good, but he hasn't to calculate so much stuff like Caruana, because Carlsen knows what to calculate. The moves, the candidate moves for the calculation, come naturally to him, and I think Caruana is more like a computer and calculates a lot more, and Carlsen maybe studied natural talents like Capablanca, Rubinstein, Karpov, Petrosian, Smyslov, and such players. And he simply knows what are good moves, which moves are necessary to calculate, and hasn't to do so much work in calculation as Fabiano Caruana. As a proof for the calculation superpowers of Fabiano Caruana, I have here a position from a game of Fabi against Vishy Anand, another world champion. It was some years ago in the Olympiad in Batumi, and here Anand with the black pieces makes the aggressive move g5. The attack knight goes back, and Anand traded the knight. Now it seems bishop f5 would be a good move, but then Fabi calculated the following variation. He can take here, and if black takes, then white takes the last piece, and we see white has more material and has a winning position. That's why bishop f5 is not so good. Instead, Anand played bishop e5. We have to say in this position there is a threat. The threat is bishop takes f6. And when the queen takes knight e4, and that's a fork on bishop d6 and queen f6, and also the rook is attacking the bishop. This wins material, and that's why black played bishop e5. Now the queen goes out of a possible pin and also has an eye to the squares f4 and the pawn on h6, which will be important later. We will see it. Now black plays bishop f5, e4 comes, bishop goes back, and f4 as planned. Now Anand miscalculated this position a little bit. He should have taken the bishop on d4 and rook ad8. This would be the best variation. Instead, he took on f4. And expected simply taking back from Caruana, because if he takes back, then he can take this bishop and the rook is not so dangerous as in the variation which Fabiano Caruana calculated better. He didn't take back immediately on f4, he made the intermezzo move bishop takes e5, because now check, king goes into the corner. Now he has a rook who is able to go to the very dangerous g file, and this is a file which is good for white and bad for black, and we will see soon why. Now black takes a hanging pawn on e4, white takes back. Now black cannot take back with the bishop because he has a problem with this double attack, this check on g2 with the queen, which wins the rook. That's not possible. That's why he took here with the rook and had in mind if white takes with the bishop, then black can take back with the bishop. And the king is in trouble, because the queen on c5 and the bishop on e4 make a lot of problems for the king. Okay. Instead, white played rook g3, and as mentioned, this g file will be d decisive for this game. Now white threatens f5, and black tried the move rook d4, a counterattack on the queen, but Fabi calculated all this and simply played queen e3, pinning the rook, and also this queen is protected by the rook, and also this queen has an eye on the pawn on h6. That's also important for the calculations. In this position, surprisingly or not, Vichy resigned because he's lost in all variations. What can he do? If he moves rook c4 or rook d5, it's the same. White simply exchanges the queens and plays f5 and wins a piece. And if he wants to save the bishop with this move and has the square h7 for the bishop, then the h6 pawn falls and it will be a checkmate soon, because all these moves, for instance rook g8, don't help. It's checkmate in 2. Or if he plays in this position queen e5, then we have another nice move, all calculated by Fabiano Caruana. f6 and checkmate on g7 will follow. And this is how Fabiano Caruana outcalculated the world champion Vichy Anand. And that's the proof, one of the many proofs. Fabiano Caruana is a very, very good calculator and is able to play a lot of very nice games and can outcalculate anyone, even a tactic monster like Anand. Okay guys, I hope you liked this video and I see you in the next one.